One of the strangest episodes in the field of exobiology is that of the meteorite Allan Hills 84001, a rock thought to have originated on Mars. While this story is obscure now, it wasn't in 1996 when a NASA researcher discovered evidence of what he believed was fossilized alien microorganisms contained within the meteorite. This claim was considered so credible at the time that United States President Bill Clinton made a public announcement that we had indeed discovered proof of alien life. The research was later called into question during peer review, but the possibility that we may have evidence for ancient microbial life on Mars remains open to this day. Allan Hills 84001 was found in Antarctica's Allan Hills on December 27, 1984 by a team of American scientists. Antarctica is an interesting place to hunt for meteorites because its landscape can be quite ancient and undisturbed. This particular meteorite is thought to have fallen about 13,000 years ago, but also for its general lower possibility of Earth contamination because Antarctica is, well, basically a giant freezer. Plus, given that we're dealing with ice sheets, most rocks that melt out of glaciers on that continent tend to be meteorites rather than terrestrial rocks because the meteorites fall on top of the ice and get buried. So, to recover meteorites in Antarctica, one simply goes to the termination point of melting glaciers to find a bonanza. Most of the meteorites found in Antarctica are pedestrian nickel iron or stony iron meteorites originating from asteroids. Rocks in the asteroid belt crash into each other and send material flying off that eventually smacks into Earth. But under certain conditions, such as a giant impact, rocks from the smaller moons and planets in the solar system can also be blasted into space. This includes our own moon, and in fact all moons, but Mars is also just small enough for material to be ejected from it during large impacts. The Martian meteorites are a small group of meteorites found mostly in Antarctica that appear to be from the surface of Mars. Called SNCs, after the first letters of the names of the first three meteorites of this type to be identified, they contain chemical elements that match Mars's geological and atmospheric makeup. They tend to be less interesting volcanic basalts of the type that the various Mars rovers ignore on the surface of Mars, but the 4.3-pound Allan Hills 84001 meteorite is different. For one, it's unbelievably old. It's considered to be one of the oldest objects in the solar system at 4.091 billion years. While it is a basalt, it's a really early one from a time when Mars had abundant liquid water. This is interesting because most of the Martian meteorites, some of which also have odd lifelike structures in them which could be contamination or something else, date from the current dry period of Martian history. Though even that is in question, as briny liquid water springs still appear to exist on the surface of Mars. We also have a possible idea of where on Mars this meteorite is from. It's the largest canyon in the solar system, Valles Marineris, or the Valleys of Mariner, after the Mariner 9 probe that first saw it in 1971. As an early basalt rock, isotopic analysis showed that the carbonates contained within the meteorite appear to have precipitated out of water and contained the characteristic carbon dioxide of Mars's atmosphere. It appears that the rock might once have been part of an aquifer located a few meters beneath the surface of Mars. It's thought that the rock was blasted from Mars about 17 million years ago and spent millions of years wandering the solar system before falling in Antarctica. Under a scanning electron microscope, tiny structures were found that appeared to be fossilized bacteria. But there was a problem. They were much smaller than their Earth counterparts, orders of magnitude smaller. There is a theory in microbiology that unbelievably tiny bacteria called nanobacteria might exist. They are problematic, with most researchers agreeing that they seem to exist but probably aren't alive, yet most also agree that they seem to reproduce in some way, leading to the whole mess being dubbed the cold fusion of microbiology. That aside, even their presence on Mars would be of great interest due to the fact that the nanobacteria question is still open, and that the structures contained within the meteorite do not resemble microbial contamination found in the other Martian meteorites. In fact, they appear to be integrated into the matrix of the meteorite itself in such a way that Earth contamination does not do, but it's not conclusive. And that's the problem. This all comes down to morphology. Interpreting the structure of something like the proposed fossils in the meteorite's interior is often prone to error. You need more, and that's where we start hitting walls. But there are other tantalizing hints that the structures may be the product of life, such as the carbon isotopes contained within them. But pinning everything down has proven maddeningly elusive. And it gets worse. There's another meteorite that seems to show potential evidence for life on Mars. This meteorite fell in Egypt about a century ago and reportedly vaporized a dog in the process that is believed to have Martian origins. Within this meteorite named Nakhla, after the town it fell in, tiny structures were found along with abundant carbonaceous material contained within cracks inside the basalt rock. This material resembled the traces left by bacteria in the same kinds of rocks found on Earth. The trouble is, carbon is the fourth most abundant element in the universe, so its presence doesn't necessarily mean life. Even more interesting though, amino acids were found found inside this meteorite, the building blocks of life, but it's not clear if they are contamination or original to the rock. Once again, it can't be pinned down conclusively. So did Mars once harbor microbial life? Well, we know it had the conditions for it in the distant past. In fact, it was actually more hospitable to life in the past than Earth was when life first arose here. That's led to a theory called panspermia, which suggests that life originally arose on Mars, but was deposited here by a meteorite. That's right, it's possible that we, and all life on Earth, aren't native to this world. But that's a subject for another video. But the only way to know for sure that Mars once had life, it seems, is to simply go there and find out. With the discovery of the briny springs, that would imply that active aquifers still exist on Mars and might still harbor life to this day. If not, returning pristine samples of the type of rock that composes Allan Hills 84001 would go a long way in laying the fossil question to rest. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, a day late with my latest video due to a misbehaving laptop computer. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for in-depth, regular explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.